Hey, I'm Steven Kolchitsky, creator of Galici Archives. In this video, I'm going to show you how to find documents such as metrical books, premarital questionnaires, and more using the TS Style Lviv Archives website. Now, if you like this video, you know what to do, so let's get started. Okay, so to start, let's go to the address tsstyle.archives.gov.ua as is written up here in the address bar, or click on the link that I left for you in the details section below the video. Now, the first thing you do when you get to this site is up here on the right-hand side in the address bar. Click on it. It's the Google Translate symbol. And select English, or your language of choice. And select Always Translate Ukrainian, and you're done. Now, here on the main page, we have updates that were recently done to the website, the first point of the list. And as for the other points, I'll let you go through them on your own, not to take too much time in the video. Now, the two points we're going to be using today is Apparatus and eArchive. So to start, let's go to eArchive. Now here we see six boxes, at least for now, and with time most probably more will be added as they keep updating the website. Now each box represents a collection of records. Now as you notice, the labels on each box weren't translated with Google's translator, but in a minute you'll see they translate as the first word fond being fund, and the second word opus being description. So let's go in this third box here, 132.1. And you see in the title, Fund 132, Description 1. And below that, you have a list of records. Now, the list looks a little distorted. And the reason for this, at least in my case, is Google's translator. If I put it back to Ukrainian, the list is normal. But don't let that worry you, because even though it's distorted, the individual records are still selectable. As you could see, they highlight in red when I put my cursor on top of them. The numeration system for the individual records are 132.1.1, 132.1.2, and so on and so forth. Well, this third number here is called Sprava, and Google translates it as case. And this is very important to know because this is the archive's numeration system or numeration code. So you're going to have fund as the first number, then description as the second, and case as the third. Or in Ukrainian, Fond, Opis, and Sprava. So now if we go back to our eArchive, and let's say we want to find the record 618241. Well, we go down here to 618-2, and we scroll down to 41, 618241. So now knowing this archival numeration system, what do these numbers represent? Or in other words, which records are for these numbers? Well, sometimes you'll find something like you see here on top, a description of the fund. If you click on that, it brings you to a document for that specific set of records, fund or fund 618 and opus or description 2. And this document is kind of like a table of contents for each record in that set of records. So if I go down to page 8, we see the numbers start. And those are all the Sprava numbers or the case numbers. So for each one, this is the record that it represents. Now I'm going to go through this document in a little bit more detail in a few minutes. I just want to show you one little thing. If I go to page 147, which is the end of the list, you see that after there's a list of villages that start, which like I said, I'll go over in a minute. Now this list ends at case number 3456. If I go back, I'm going to come up here, copy the address, and in a new tab, I'm going to paste the address so that I don't have to keep going back and forth in the same tab. Now, if I go to Apparatus, it brings us to a page that has different types of documents on how to navigate those records. So here we have guidebook and indicators, which I won't go over today. Then we have catalogs, which I'll go over in a few minutes. And underneath, we have descriptions, and these are documents or tables of contents, like we just saw, for each fund and description. And if I click on Control F, or the three dots, and find, and I type in fund space 618, it brings me to my fund 618 description tool, table of contents. But the difference is this one Roman Catholic Metropolitan Consistory Lviv. If I go to page 172, the list ends at 4039 and not 3456 like the other document. So basically, this table of contents here is longer than the one we saw here. But if I come here, scroll down to the bottom of the page, we see that the list ends for now at 3200. So basically, this will do the job just the same. But I'm just showing you about this document so you know. And at the same time, it opens in a separate tab, not like the other one did in the same tab. Now let's go to page one, and I'll go over this table of contents in a little bit more detail. So here we have Roman Catholic Metropolitan Consistory of Lviv, obviously Fund 618 Description 2. And as we scroll down, we come to a list of abbreviations. Here's the translations if you want to make note of them. And as we scroll down, we come to our table of contents. And now just to go over it real quick, this number one represents 618.2.1. If I want 10, it's 618.2.10, and so on and so forth. Now, if you would want to know what this means, I'm assuming you don't speak Ukrainian, you could always open a new tab and do a search for Google Translator. Select Ukrainian. Come here. Select this. Control C or copy text. Control V or paste. And you have your information translated. And here, the same. As you could see, it means the same. But I don't think you'll want to go through all these documents and have to translate each and every one. So to use this document, what you would want to do is, again, Control F and look for the name of the village you want to find. Now you might get lucky if you put the Polish version of it. For example, if I want to look for Kurwanówka, enter, you see I come up with nothing. If I put the O with an accent, because that's the way it was spelled, I still get nothing. If I take this Kurwanówka, copy it, and put it in Google, I get it on Wikipedia. I see the Ukrainian version of it, so I select that, Control C. I go back to my PDF file, Control V to paste it up here, enter, and it brings me to everywhere in the document where Kurdebanivka is written. Now here we see Kurdebanivka. We will find records from 2015 to 2027 and 3014. So knowing this, I could come to my records and I could do Control F 2015. And from here all the way up to 2027, I know that they will have records on the village I'm looking for. And if I go back to my table of contents and I scroll up to 2015, well, here I have a description of what 2015 has and what 2016 has. And then the same, but for these years and so on and so forth. Also, we have, which I didn't cover before, the year range, the number of pages, and the language of the document or the record. And again, if I want to know what this means, I could always select it, copy text, up to my translator, Control V, and I have my information here. Now this table of contents looks pretty nice and handy, but it's not the same for all the records. Let me close this and go back to my e-archive. If I look at Fund 7, Opus 1. I'll come up here, Fund 7, space, enter. And when I click on my description 1, this is the type of table of contents that I get. It's the scan of an actual book. So I can't do a find on this page or select something to put in Google Translate. And as I scroll down, we get to our table of contents. And again, if I close this, if I want to know what 3101 is, I come here, Fund 310, Ukrainian University in Lviv. And I click on that, and it brings me to another scanned table of contents. And if I want to zoom in, and the same thing as the previous one we just saw, we can't select anything or do a find search. All right, so let's get out of here and let's go back to the top of the page. Now let's take a look at catalogs because this is really interesting. If I go to the second one, Roman Catholic, since we were just looking at this Roman Catholic collection of records, I'll select that. And that brings me to a catalog of Roman Catholic metrical books. Now, if I go to page 5, we see for each village, we have information given. But now how to make out this information? Well, if I scroll up, we have a page and each number represents something. So here's a translation of what each number represents as well as what each abbreviation means. And you might want to take this down on paper or a screenshot of it so you could have at hand when it comes time to go through this list. So now if we look at the first village, Andriani for the county Rudke, we have number 3, the name of the religious institution or parish. And we see parafia, parish, is in Komarno. Then for number 5, which represents birth records, we have for these years, birth records found at this archival code. So now look at this, 618 to 2692. We go back to our 618 to, Control F, 2692, and we have 618 to 2692, these birth records. And underneath we could see number 6, marriage records, number 7, death records. For these years will be found there as well. Then for this year range in birth records, we'll find it at 3515. And here, number 11, we have for additional information, fragment. If we were to copy that, go to our translator, Control V, we see what the translation is. So you see, it's really helpful to have a few tabs open on top. And the same thing, if I want to look for a certain village, because I'm not going to look at the records of each village. Well, if I want to look for my Kurdvanovka or Kurdemanovka, I'll just click up here on the magnifying glass or Control F. Come here, Control C, Control V, enter. And it shows me in the document everywhere where Kurdebaniówka is found. Now you see here, the Polish version is there. So I might have had luck doing a search on the Polish version of it. But if you look up here in the parish village, the Polish version is not written. So if you would have done a search on the Polish version of Petlikivci Stary, which is Petlikovci Stary, you would have came up empty handed. So my best advice for you is find the Ukrainian version and put that in your find bar or your search bar. Now, if the village is not in Wikipedia, you could always open up a new tab and go to Google Maps and put the name of the village that you're looking for. And here in the information bar, you're going to find its writing in Ukrainian. You could select that, Control C, and you could put that up here and you're good to go. So to go over this one more time real quick, for number 2, we have the name of the parish and its county. For number 4, we have the name of the villages that are within that parish. For number 5, we have years and the corresponding archival code for births. Then the same thing for marriages at number 6 and deaths at number 7. And if I go to the next Kurdebaniówka, it'll show me the village name in a list, which is at the end of this document. And it says, si selo, a village, Povit Buchach in the county Buchach, and Ternopilske Voivodstvo in the Ternopil province. And here, div, it means si, parish, Petlikivtsi. So this is an extra little information for each village. And now, if I go back to my Kurdbanivka information, if I want to go to Birts 1820 to 1823, I'll go to my 618 to 2016, 2016, and I'll select this record. And it brings me to the metrical books for my village from 1820 to 1823. Here on the bottom left, we have the archival code 618 to 2016. And here we go. My records. Now you might recognize the homepage because many of these records could also be found on Family Search, but it's still good to know how to navigate the TS Dial site. Now, if I go back to my catalogs, let's look at another one, Greek Catholic parishes. And we have a catalog that works in the exact same manner. So page 6 is pretty much the same principle as in the Roman Catholic catalog. Here we have a few more abbreviations. Here's the translations. And as we go down, it starts again, one being for this province and the list of villages. Now, as you could see here, 201 for A is pretty much Greek Catholic records. But when I go to E archive, we don't see any 201 for A. So unfortunately, they don't have Greek Catholic records, at least yet. And the same principle, if I go down to the bottom of the catalog, we have our list of villages with corresponding information. So I'm going to get out of here. And I'll go back to my catalogs. Let's look at the Orthodox parishes. And if I go to page 4, we have our information sheet. And as I scroll down, well, we have our catalog. And as you see, a lot of these villages make reference to Fund 201 description 4A. Well, as I said before, unfortunately, we don't have it. So I'm going to close this, come here, and we're going to do a quick example. So let's say I want to look for the parish Stara Sul in the county Stara Sambir. Well, I'm going to come up here, open a new tab, type in my Stara Sul. I could either select the Wikipedia one, but I prefer the map. I'll zoom out a little. I see it's in the Stara Sambir county. So now that I know it's the right one, I'll copy its Ukrainian version, paste it in the find bar, and I could go through the results. And sure enough, I find a nice set of records for Stara Sil in Stari Sambir. And I have at number 4, the villages that are within this parish. Number 5, I have the corresponding birth records. Number 6, the corresponding marriage records. And number 8, the corresponding premarital questionnaire tests. And that, my friends, is how you could find metrical books on the TSDI website. Well, I hope this video was helpful. I hope it gave you a better understanding of how you could navigate through the TSDI website. If you did like the video, you know what to do. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.